Broadcasting 24-7. You know what that is. 24 hours a day, 365 days a year. 366 if it's a leap year. DTFradio.com. We never stop.
Yo, this is 50 Cent.
It's your boy Wiz Khalifa, man.
Hey, this your boy Chris Brown.
It's your boy Drizzy Drake.
Yo, this is your boy Weezy.
And now do it.
DJ.
Hey, what's up? It's Jay-Z.
It's Tiger Young Money Zone.
What up, y'all? This is J. Cole.
And it's your boy, Big Sean.
This is Kanye West.
It's what y'all all been waiting for, ain't it?
DJ Giovanni Bad.
Okay. Okay. We live.
Video team, man. Video
team, man. Repping the MikeyJackClub.com. DTF Radio. Party and bullshit. Somebody get ugly in this bitch.
That's your bitch. I'ma hit that bitch for a minute. You can have this bitch in a minute.
Shouts to everybody in the building. Shouts to all the ladies. Shouts to all the cameramen. Shouts to all the guests, whatever. Shouts to the big homie Jack Thriller. Shouts to the bros, twin in the club. Official Burn. Too many names to mention, but I'm gonna try to get to everybody. Shouts to the guests coming in today. The big homie Smack, the originator. The real Smack White himself.
That's your bitch. I'ma hit that bitch.
Yep.
You can have that bitch in a minute. Probably fuck that bitch for a minute. Don't bitch wanna fuck on me, cause I flex all year and you flex for a minute. Grown up, we got tracks on day, clip long video, yeah, that bitch hang for a minute. I just wait on sacks like a bitch, so bitch tryna fuck with that.
Okay.
Fuck out, bitch, I ain't fuckin' while I'm sippin'. Fuck around, fall asleep while I'm in it. I just gave bitch, we be running through the cat.
See Doc Honcho. Wait a minute.
That's just for that ass. Man, I can't stop this
ass. Okay. It's the boy Giovanni Bat, St. Mark's, Norston Ave, Crown Heights, Brooklyn.
What? What?
Wait.
What? What?
Remix featuring the big homie 50.
What? What? Wait a minute.
Wait.
Wait a minute.
Wait.
One goddamn minute.
Wait.
Oh Lord, wait a minute.
Party and bullshit each and every Monday, DTF Radio, 3 to 4.
What?
Paulus, what up?
What? 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 What?
Asia, Dope, Isabel, Michelle, Amanda, Sophia, Goody, Nancy, Fancy, Daisy, Dama, Dinky, Bella,
don't save her, she don't wanna be saved.
L'Oreal,
do a dirt up on my lonely. All my bitches know he homie. If I pull up with my bitch hoes, better act like they don't know. I'm a side bitch is in check. Diamonds clear like Windex. One point of the index. So the west,
let's go.
So you better be cool. Shawty better be new. When I walk in a room, she knows she fucking with a goon.
Yep.
She don't mean at the same time. My third leg got hang time.
Bang, 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 bang
time. Gay face when it's game time. He ain't the lead scorer. Gotta scream it like a horror.
I said it was the remix, right?
Stop. But she really want more of.
Boy, now what's the issue? You finna make me get with you.
you won't talk that girly talk, bitch, you talking about? Wait. I got big paper, I'm spinning. I get the flashing on them, I will blast it on them. I mean, any nigga can get it. Got 30 in the extender. I had your bitch in the end zone. Nigga, she sucked me out the friend zone. I'm so good with the hoes. I pulled up in the rows with my diamonds blinking like strobes. And a Kanye shirt with hoes. I'm blowing paper like that. My niggas in here strapped. Their boss, you won't bust back. That's why I act how I act. I see it all so clear. You niggas ain't really, really with the shit. Hey. Got me thinking I really, 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 really run.
Last joint, then we get down to business.
Party and bullshit radio show. DTF Radio, you know what it is. It's your girl, Lorby L.
Your girl, Sophia Body.
We got a bunch of
bad bitches.
You already know.
We'll start from this side.
What's going on, y'all? It's your girl, Asia Lovey. Y'all can find me on Instagram, Book One Asia.
What up? It's Dama Nils. You can find me anywhere. There's cool stuff happening.
Whoa. Okay.
Hey, everybody. It's Ling Ling Lex. You can find me on Instagram at @LingLingLex.
What's up, y'all? It's Ruby Rojo on the mic. You can find me at Ruby Rojo anywhere.
Hey. This is Goody. You can follow me on IG at This Is Goody. Simple.
This is your girl, Sophia Body, and you can find me on IG at Sophia Body. Twitter, Sophia Body.
Yes, and this is your girl, L'Oreal, and you can find me starring L'Oreal, everything. And, you know, this is a man's dream right here. That's what I think. You can, a man come in here, he gonna lose his motherfucking mind. I don't know what y'all think.
For real.
Or nightmare if we in a bad mood.
Yeah, right.
Yeah. We still got some more ladies in the building. We can't leave nobody out.
We're gonna be switching in and out, so it's gonna be, y'all gonna hear a lot of different ladies. So let's keep it going.
Hey, I'm Isabel. She is Isabel on IG.
This is your girl, Dope. You can find me Dope Since 87 _80s Baby Rock.
Since 87, wow. Be clear.
Hola, everybody. It's Jenny Ranks, and you can follow me on Jenny Ranks, and that's everything, Jenny Ranks.
Ladies, when you guys are speak into the mic. We got to speak. We got to make these people hear us.
Y'all know how to speak into the mic. Don't be
into
shy.
Into the mic.
Don't be shy.
Put that party voice on. You know what I'm saying? Party voice. No stop voices up in here.
Don't be scared. I know too, so.
Hey, y'all. This is Korea Michelle. You can find me on IG and Twitter.
This is your girl, Kira Diva. You can find me on IG. I am Kira27 and Facebook and Twitter, Kira Diva.
Hi, Chanel. You can find me at Bella Nels on IG and Snapchat.
Hey, it's your girl, Fancy. You can catch me at Oshi Fancy with 2 H's _ at the end.
What's up? It's the only girl DJ here. I'm DJ Daisy Dukes.
Right. Yeah!
Y'all can just Google DJ Daisy Dukes. That's what's up.
Yes.
What's
so
up?
Much estrogen. I love it.
What's up? I'm Eva Evans at Dinky on Instagram. 2 I's, 2 Y's.
Okay.
Are we still going? I'm not sure. Is it? Is that it?
There's too many.
Is that enough?
That's good.
Is that enough? Okay. So yeah, we're gonna have Smack in here today. He's gonna be our motherfucking guest.
URL King.
Yeah, you already
himself.
Know. Everybody know who he is. So he, you know, he a legend in these streets.
He gonna have some fun up in here.
That's right.
We already having fun. We came in having fun.
Wait.
So y'all gotta catch up. Exactly. What's our DJ doing over there though? I ain't hear you.
Trying to get it to move to the side.
Ringing and say something to the people real quick.
This is Party of Bullshit, man. Like, shout out to everybody that came through. Shout out to everybody in here. The vibe, the energy, we gonna bring that energy to the people. We trying to, really bring a new platform as far as, like, the whole Black Lives Matter, whatever. We gonna use this platform to let them know you can be a thug and still be educated at the same time.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Or so white.
That's what it is.
Or white.
But you think Black Lives Matter too? All Black Lives Matter.
All lives matter. All lives matter.
All pussies matter too. So we got
all pussy sure. Matter.
Hey, cycle sisters.
Exactly. Shout out to Jack Thriller. You know, we got to make sure we shout the homie out.
Shout out to Jackie Jack
for bringing us all together.
Unified unification.
Yeah, there we go. So you know what?
What y'all want to get started on? What we going to talk about right now? Oh, I figured.
Oh, wow.
I figured it was going to be Kim K. What'd she do? Okay, so let's give the backstory. Yesterday, last night, Kim K, allegedly, I don't know, you know, I wasn't there, but she supposedly got robbed for $10 million worth of jewelry.
Her wedding ring included.
Her wedding ring. Well, yeah, engagement ring. And, I mean, you know, I'm not saying it's true. I'm not saying it's false. I'm saying this is what
we're reporting. I think it's an insurance scam.
Do you?
Yeah. I'm gonna get cut down.
She pulling insurance scams, man.
How is she not? No,
Kanye
how
definitely
is she not
walked
there
off
alone?
The stage.
How is she there alone? But he was 20. When is ever Kim anywhere alone without security, without anybody? That doesn't make sense.
Well, they said that they tied up the security. They said it was a concierge, whatever. They said that they tied him up, and he's the person that led them to the door and also opened the door for them. That's also an insurance scam.
It's speculation that it's an inside job because there's five guys. They're saying they're looking for five suspects.
Yeah, well, I know they were dressed up as police officers, but they were also masked. So I don't know how that works because I don't know no masked police officers that just walk around knocking on doors like, hey.
That's why they suspect that it's an inside job.
Really?
And the fact that they fled on bicycles with $10 million worth of jewelry. Like,
it doesn't make sense. It doesn't make sense.
But for her, $10 million worth of jewelry is two pieces. Let's be clear. Like, this ain't the kind of jewelry we talking about.
No, they said they said they got away with a box of jewelry.
Because I know that
the ring was $4 million, and they said it was a box of jewelry that was estimated at 6.7.
That jewelry box probably cost a rack by itself.
Exactly. Right? A rack, more than that.
I think that...
Oh, I hear that.
Look for the five guys that all just went out and bought brand new cars, right? In France, right?
I don't know. That's illegal.
That's an insurance scam.
She got a lot of money, though. And I would say also on top of that,
or publicity stunt, something. They've been getting a lot of talk, like a lot of backlash, Kim. So she probably want people to feel sorry for her or something.
And I ain't gonna lie, the family always got a scheme or a scam.
Don't put that shit past.
Yo, Kris Jenner is behind everything.
Right.
Solange got
an incredible album.
But listen. How all this happened, she was traveling with her mom. So where was her mom at?
That's what I'm saying. She's
when
never
she got robbed. So
Kim Kardashian
like,
is. If you have over $1 million worth of jewelry, you're never gonna be alone. That doesn't
listen,
make sense.
If she's taking a shit or going to sleep, I'm pretty sure her ass is alone.
Yo.
She ain't nobody sitting on that toilet with that girl. It was 3 a.m.
There's always security outside the door, let me tell you.
They said they tied him up.
That don't make sense to me.
Me either, but you know, this is what they saying. I wasn't there.
They ran up on the plug.
I don't got no $4 million ring on me.
Look, on the next season of Keeping Up with the Kardashians.
Yeah, right, right.
And we got Robin China.
Robin China. Does anybody watch that show?
I've seen a couple episodes.
I do.
You do? Okay, we got one person out of 50,000 in the room.
I'm surprised she watched Snap when it happened.
I'm not gonna lie. I watched one episode and after that I was done. When she was calling him a bitch and she was on the phone with,
why you texting bitches?
Yeah, she was like, you a bitch. Why you texting bitches?
That was smart. He didn't change his number. He did not change his number.
Wow.
He didn't change his number. After she gave it out, he still didn't. Are you sure? It's like Mike Jones. Everybody got that nigga number.
He didn't change his number.
The only thing I got from that show is that Rob is so insecure with himself.
I mean, we know
so
that.
But it's just like, OD, like, why are you on TV with cameras all over you if you're just
he
like,
has,
yo,
he has
I'm
no
fat,
choice.
I hate myself.
Okay. Look at the family that he came from. Because it sounds like you're trying to throw like
Shay, I feel bad for Rob. Don't go that way, because you're going to make China seem like she's saving him. Don't do that.
Rob is rich. I do not feel bad for her.
But if you're walking around like, I hate these cameras, I hate people around me, I don't want to go to my sister's party.
You have no choice. You're part of the Kardashian family.
He has a choice to be on that show.
You don't. You
didn't. He had a choice to be on that show.
He needs to make money. How else is he going to make money?
He hates what he does. They got money. He don't need to make no money. They got money.
But he needs to make his own self-substantial.
They always
have. He needs to make his own self-substantial.
Okay, who in here, say I, who in here would fuck Rob Kardashian?
I.
It ain't just one person I would fuck. One person out of
Listen,
all y'all
I would fuck him
Rob.
If he wasn't so
honest
weird.
Honest person. I would date him and marry him. He's a nice person.
Yeah,
and he's cute.
Looks.
I don't think there's
looks.
Nothing wrong with him. I mean, he's
a little
heavy.
Overweight, but who hasn't fucked an overweight nigga before?
Nah, fat dudes is where it's
That's
at.
Called a ball of belly. A ball of belly.
I have never. I have never had sex with a guy that was overweight, but I would date Rob. He's a nice guy. He's cute when he loses the weight, and he's a sweetheart. But I would date him. And
I like him chunky.
Yeah, he's not.
I wouldn't.
I think
China puts
chunky.
The pressure on him to be in the spotlight. He just wants a normal relationship to be happy, but yeah, with the wrong girl.
It's not gonna get normal when you're having sex with your sister's. What is it? What is Tiger?
That's not
the family tree.
It was always gonna be a problem.
Everybody's fucking everybody.
Exactly.
They all fuck game.
The
they all fuck. Remember,
sisters.
He said he fucked
Khloe and
Khloe,
Kim,
oh, the
Kim
and
yeah.
China,
which she's a Kardashian.
Oh, that. But you know what's funny? The game calls Meek a rat, but then you want a rat on the Kardashians for sleeping with them. So who's really? You can't.
Oh, so wait. Now we talking about game.
Yeah. Now I switched it to game because that shit is messed up. How are you gonna call somebody a rat, but you ratting on who you slept with? That's a level of rat.
I mean, I feel like everything about the game and Meek beef is so weird to me because they telling on each other, they talking about each other, they talking about each other, talk too much. It's just. All I want to do is hear the music. So
stop kicking
know,
Meek when he's down.
I don't care about the Instagram stuff. I don't care about the Twitter stuff. All I want to hear is the music. And I'm not going to lie. Game went in
it's
on that.
Though,
ooh.
Because it's
stop kicking Meek.
That game went in.
I haven't heard it.
Game went in on that. Ooh, but Meek went in on Flex.
I heard Meek on.
I got it right here. You gonna hear it.
Yeah, let's see. Let's play
are you
that.
Playing the game one? Because
I got both of them.
The game one. And then, you know, the Beanie Siegel shit, and he done got knocked out behind it, and it's just all kind of stuff going on.
I don't know.
Then they
got to get it together.
They got Maino involved. They got all kinds
of... Yeah, how? And Uncle Murder, like, I'm out. Like, you got to leave this shit alone.
We
going
to do the Meek or the game first?
The game, please.
No. Listen to me.
We going
to
have a vote. Meek or game?
No, I'm going to tell you what happened, though.
Game.
Meek put his out first, so we going to do it in the order that it came out.
Say no more.
True.
Let's go. Party and Bullshit Radio.
That's right.
DTF.
With the limits, squeeze like simply. Riding dirty. None of the real niggas in Cali fuck with you, nigga. You know I'm plugged in.
Ha.
You know who this is talking, pussy. You always show me the utmost respect, nigga.
We got the big homie in the building, man.
Nothing in your life.
And we talking about beef. We talking about battle. We got that nigga in the building.
And I'm gonna fuck around. Why you worry about me? Sit your gay ass down. Acting like you that nigga when you a fucking clown. You are a rumble. I got the 30.
We got Smack and Beasley and Heineken.
Hey.
What's up? Get your mic.
Pass Smack
down. Live in the building, man. We got the big homie Smack, the originator.
Schmurr.
Far back as the Smack DVDs, you know what I'm saying? I'm sure a lot of us grew up on that. Hype to see them shits coming out, you know what I'm saying? Shouts to the big homie in the building, man. Welcome to Party and Bullshit.
Welcome,
we really happy to have you here, especially the ladies.
Wow.
What's up? Thank you for having me.
Yo, I'm super excited right now.
Yo, so Smack, let's get right into the questions, man. What was the...
Yeah. Wait.
She ain't wasting no time. She's like, yo, let's get straight to it.
I mean, we know who he is, but we still got to let him introduce himself and all that.
And, you know...
So you know, you in the building with us, Smack. You can introduce yourself to the people.
Yes. You already know, man. In case y'all don't know me, I'm Smack. You know what I'm saying? Smack DVD, URL TV. I represent for the battle culture. You know what I'm saying? I'm in the streets heavy. You know what I'm saying? I'm out here. You know what I'm saying? Partying bullshit. What's up? Let's get it popping.
Right.
And who's to your left? Left.
Yeah.
Oh. Heineken.
Okay.
Introduce yourself.
Oh, you just here.
Oh, Heineken just here. All right, so Beasley.
Know. Yeah, you know L'Oreal, my favorite rapper. I need music for you. Sophie, my favorite Canadian. How you feeling, dog?
Oh, my God.
We got Beasley right here, the moneymaker. All right. I know you.
Oh, Beasley don't talk. Beasley don't talk. All right.
You know what I mean?
Smack, what's good? I haven't seen you in like years.
You've been in my age, you know what I mean? But it's all good, you know.
I'll be there at the next one. The next one, I'm there.
You know, you always gotta come through. You always welcome and shit. Everybody's welcome, you know what I'm saying? For our next You Are Relevant, y'all all gotta come through and show love.
When is it?
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I've never been invited.
We all coming.
November 20th, you know what I'm saying? Urban Plaza, you know what I'm saying?
Oh, you got the venue?
Yeah, we back over there, but you know what I'm saying? Y'all good, y'all gonna be safe. You
wanna make sure? I ain't gonna lie. I don't know about that, bro.
You know what I mean?
I might not be with you on that, baby. I'll get you at the next one.
You just got to stay close. Stay close to me.
Smack.
Nothing happening to me, for real.
You have the lineup already for the 20th?
Nah, I don't got the lineup yet. You know what I'm saying? You know, they still basically negotiating a couple of deals and deal points with a couple of MCs. So, you know what I'm saying? I'm releasing the information probably like within the next 2 weeks.
Can I ask a super question?
What's up?
Is Cassidy going to be up in there? Cassidy's going to be up in there!
I mean, he more than welcome to come. You know, that's my boy. You know what I'm saying? He do, you know, be popping up at the URL event, you know what I mean, here and there. So, you never
he's
know
saying he wanna,
if
he want to
come through.
He want to verse...
Yeah, I would love to see it, you know what I'm saying? But, you know, that's heavy negotiations, and, you know what I'm saying? I have yet to have an opportunity to speak to him, but, you know what I mean? That's a conversation
Suge
I'm looking
versus
forward
Cassidy,
to,
what's up?
Having with, you know what I mean, Cassidy, for real.
She about to do the whole lineup for you, so you might as well
just... I know.
That,
that's the code D. Like, she be holding me down, like, yo, Smack, what's up? You want another Henny? What's up?
Nice,
That, you know what I'm saying? For real.
After the Joe Budden situation, do you think you still want to mess with, like, mainstream rappers and, put them on as battle rappers that don't really be battling like that?
Absolutely. I mean, you know, Joe Buttons, I felt Joe Buttons did all right, you know what I mean? Except for dropping the mic and shit, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
that was... Moves number one, you know what I'm saying, when it comes to the battle rap shit, you know what I'm saying? You got to hold your mic, you know what I'm saying? But, Joe Buttons did all right, you know what I mean? I can't really take nothing away from him, but, like, you know what I mean? I would love to see, like, more mainstream artists coming to the culture, so you know what I mean, we can really put on for this art form and just show the world that, you know what I mean, this art form got a lot of substance when it comes to the culture of hip-hop, you know what I'm saying?
How and why did you transition from doing Smack through the DVD with like hip-hop lifestyle beef to just now?
That's a good question.
Doing battle rap, you know?
Well, you know what I'm saying? I used to do the rappers and all that, interview them, videos for them.
Yeah, like a little segment.
Yeah, like, you know what I mean, and all that. But, like, when technology caught up with times and everybody started having their own cameras and cell phones,
and
it didn't matter who was getting a story from these rappers. You know, all the blogs are so thirsty for content, they're going to post it. And that content and that type of style of interview from the rappers just lost value, you know what I'm saying? It depreciated because, you know, everybody was running around with cameras. So, you know what I'm saying? I had to just organize and concentrate, you know, on hip-hop entertainment, which was battle rap, you know what I'm saying? That's a new form of hip-hop entertainment, and it's something that's real, you know, entertaining.
It's not really
culture.
New. It's new for the people, like, new for this generation. Like, it's really popular right now for this generation, whereas before it was, like, underground battle rap, but now there's a lot more,
it's a lot more cultivated. Battle rap has always been around forever, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
Like, if you look at the 8 Miles, Eminem, and, you know.
And that just goes with her question. You might have answered that a million times before, but we know that you don't do very many interviews, and she's asking that, I feel like, on behalf of the newer generation that's coming up that has maybe no knowledge of where you come from, you know?
But you know, it was like, it's two different styles of battle rap now. It was battle rap with, you know, when you rhyming against a beat, and then it's battle rap what we do, where we was the first to start the, like, service around the world
battle.
On Smack DVD. It's acapella when it's round for round. Like, we created a sport out of it. You know what I mean? They ain't gonna take that away from you. You know what I'm saying? Because people gotta know. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, it's two different. precise, but you know what I mean? We represent the acapella style of battle rap, where it's round for round, where it's like a sport, like a boxing match, where, you know, you can really, you know,
the
hear
females.
Two MCs go back and forth for three rounds and just hear lyrical combat. You know what I'm saying? For
yeah.
Real.
But Smack, I'm sorry. I'm over here in the corner.
I'm looking all around and shit like, yo.
Yeah, Smack, there's 100 bitches.
We
got to
follow y'all from the DVD.
Oh, what's up? Asia in the building.
Now, you know we've been following y'all from the DVDs.
Yeah.
For the Freestyle Fridays, what do we have to look forward to? What is your brand bringing to us next?
Oh, I mean, we bring nothing but exclusive content. You know what I'm saying? We got interviews. We got battle rap. You know, we got movies, skits, everything that,
maybe
you know,
a reality show coming?
Maybe. You know what I'm saying? You know, we got a lot of different things that, you know what I'm saying, we got going on. We got a lot of conversations going on with some networks, so... You know, hopefully they'll look, you know, into like what we're doing, and you know, we could get something major popping.
Does that mean that you're gonna stop if the right offer or opportunity comes? That you're gonna stop actually holding these events and doing it
never.
For TV?
No.
Because the feel, I don't know if you never. Guys ever been to URL.
That's
about,
the hustle. Like you never
rap.
Forget where you come from. Like, you know what I mean?
Even
you,
if you can't
you
be
know,
there, there's
I mean,
someone.
Yeah, when we first started, we used to start. When we first started, we was basically doing battles in the parks and barbershops and on the corner, you know.
It.
So now, you know, that's just the blueprint. Like, that's our bread and butter. That's our foundation. So we always got to make sure that our foundation is secured, and we always going to continue to, you know, keep doing these events because, you know, the fans and the people want them. You know, we appreciate this art form. It's an art form, so we got to definitely keep promoting it and nurturing it so it can grow, you know. And it's grown so crazy because now you see battle rap leagues in all different territories of the world.
And now you in L.A.
UK,
now you in L.A.
Japan, Philippines, you know, so it's
Russia.
It's basically a growing phenomenon that, you know, people really love. So, you know what I mean? We definitely got to keep elaborating on it and growing and nurturing it. So, you know what I mean? It could continue to grow.
So, what would you say was your favorite battle, and who's your favorite battle rapper?
Oh, man.
You got to pick somebody. Don't say nobody. Don't say everybody.
I say Rock My Gunner. That's my
Jada Gunner, man.
Wait.
That's no secret.
Smack, what was your favorite battle of Born Legacy 3? And who's your favorite battle rapper?
Born Legacy 3 was a crazy, crazy, crazy event. You know what I'm saying? I'm gonna have to go with Ill Will and Rum Nitty on that one. You know what I'm saying? I think that battle is the epitome of what I represent to the battle coach. I dislike two gritty, grimy street cats just talking that shit to each other and really expressing their points of view in a non-violent way and really getting to it though. You know what I'm saying? So I'm gonna have to go with Ill Will and Rum Nitty on that one. And I think that's one of the best battles of this year, you know what I mean, 2016, for real.
So like she asked you, who's your favorite battle rapper?
I said Tay Rock.
Oh, okay, I missed that.
I said Tay Rock. Oh, Jay.
Yeah,
Tay Rock,
see?
You know what I'm saying? But you know.
What about,
question.
What's up, baby? How you doing?
So, how you doing?
What's your name?
Isabel.
What's up, Izzy? Izzy in the building. Izzy in the building.
Jack wanted me to ask this question. What's up with the battle with you and Jack?
Oh, man. Oh, shit. Where Jack at? We got a round right now, Jack.
I see that.
We can do a round right now. Nah, I ain't fucking with Jack. Jack can come out here. Jack has been writing for me for years. Jack been writing for me for years on the low.
Oh, but shit.
Me and Jack,
ghost
we might have to do a one rounder real quick.
Yeah, no, y'all should do it right now. Let's
do that shit right now,
man.
Do that shit right now. Right now, Jackie.
Let's go.
Pull up, Jackie. Pull up, Jack.
Come on. He ready.
Set that shit up, man.
Ready.
Yo, he on that effing
he
right
little
now.
Scared.
Don't let
Yo,
that effing
Smack.
Get to your head, homie. Don't
Smack.
Let that effing get
he
to your
acting
head,
like
homie.
DNA. I was supposed to battle rap DNA.
Huh?
And he acting like DNA, getting scared and all that.
I'm gonna write
Talking
you,
about
Jack.
Madness, whatever happened to your summer madness?
Yeah, summer madness.
Situation you
well,
had
you know, I mean, we faced a lot of obstacles this year. You know what I'm saying? It was a crazy year for us, the URL. You know what I'm saying? Having a foundation in New York City. A lot of shit, real shit happened in the city. You know what I'm saying? Unfortunately, there was a situation that took place in one of the venues that we happened in, you know what I'm saying? That just basically shut down the city.
Okay.
You know what
How
I mean?
How do you keep yourself, really maintained, like, with...
you know, not having to smack people. And, oh, goody.
Yeah, y'all gotta say y'all name.
I'm sorry about that.
I wanna know who's who. What up, goody?
What up?
What's goody, goody?
What's up? What up, smack? Yeah, as I'm saying, how you keep your beard so laced, you know, without letting everybody get you all crazy, without having to use a smack cam on niggas?
I got a personal Dominican that, you know what I mean, nurses and take care of my, you know what I'm saying?
The ladies like it. It tickles. Ticklish.
Smack, I have a question.
If y'all see me on, you know what I'm saying, 142 on Broadway, just understand. Y'all know what time it is. That's what I'm saying.
Ladies love a beard.
Yeah, I've never seen it like looking so fluffy. Yeah, looks like fluffy and combed and groomed.
All right, smack. Do you comb it 100 times a day? How does it work? Like,
I don't carry combs. I like it for real. Like, I really don't.
Does it get in the way of you eating pussy?
That was my next question.
I mean, sometimes it do. If it depends, if I have it up, you know, I'll be having my shit braided sometimes. Yeah. But if I have it out, you know what I mean?
So
she
when
might
you,
get
when
a little
you...
tickle here and there, you know what I'm saying? I might be tickling her.
So when it's braided, I'm staying away from you, all right? I'm not sharing my smack and Pepsi with you, my man.
I have a question for you.
What's your name?
Cocaine. So my question to you is, I heard talk of Battle of the Sexes. So is that going to happen, like URL versus Queen of the Ring?
I mean, yeah, we could do that. You know what I mean? Debo, my brother and shit, that's, you know what I mean? Somebody, one of the people that I really got respect for in this coaching.
Smack, talking in the mic, please.
You know, he always show love to, you know what I'm saying, our movement. So, you know, I won't be opposed to that, you know? If y'all want to see that, just let me know and I'll put it together.
Hell
I do
yeah.
what the people want. You know what I mean? I work for y'all on the low. You know what I'm saying? I always
you gotta
try to
include Robin Rhymes though.
Robin
all right?
Rhymes?
Yes.
Yeah. Watch.
We can't hear you.
Not because of the booty. Not because of the booty. He think I like her because she got a fat booty.
You like her though, or you don't like her?
But
why you like
I like
her
what
though?
She says. You know, I hear her. I don't look at her like that. So.
Okay.
Oh, excuse
She's
me.
Not,
okay,
that's
but
not
told
type.
You,
that's
Heineken.
Not your type? Is that your type?
And I want to touch the topic that they already touched as far as like Gnome and stuff being canceled this year. Does it have anything to do
Gnome
with
Gnome and canceled, baby? Gnome
well,
happened
back?
On November 20th. Let me get it right. You know what I mean? Summer Madness is canceled.
Okay.
Just due to the fact that, you know what I'm saying, our whole itinerary got thrown off when that incident happened at Irving Plaza.
Okay.
You know what I mean? It really threw off our schedule. And to basically try to hold a Summer Madness in a short time frame, and it won't be exactly what I would want it to be. I ain't really want to force the situation and you know, sacrifice the integrity of the Summer Madness brand.
Okay.
You understand what I'm saying? So I'll just cancel, I'll postpone it, and then, you know, next year we're going to do Summer Madness extra crazy. Just for, you know what I mean, the inconvenience for all the fans that really appreciate Summer Madness.
Okay, because the talk was that it was like the numbers that some of the battle rappers was asking for was like kind of outlandish.
I mean, we always go through that for every event, you know what I'm saying? It's basically negotiations and shit like that, you know. It's an industry now. You know what I'm saying? We single-handedly built a new industry inside the culture of hip-hop where, you know what I'm saying, MCs that love to battle rap could actually run around city to city to get paid and feed their families and shit like that.
Okay.
So you got to give it up for, you know what I'm saying, me and my brother, my organization, my team, because that's what we provide, even though they don't like to give us credit for it. But you know what I'm saying, at the end of the day, you know, this is our culture.
I got a question.
So if you're running around and you're getting paid in battle rap, you know what I mean? Thank us, please.
Right.
You know what I'm
smack.
Saying?
Smack. This Nancy over here. Over
you
here.
Know what I mean?
Smack. Hey, Smack, I got a question.
What's up? What's
your
name?
What kind of,
what would
you do a battle?
What's your name?
I did.
I'm not answering no questions.
My bad. I'm sorry. Nancy. All right,
what up, Nancy?
All right. So my question is, like, what would you do like a battle for like Black Lives Matter? Like, would you incorporate something like that for like, you know what I'm saying, like how dudes
Absolutely.
Would go and do
just
something?
Just to bring awareness to, you know what I'm saying, that whole movement, because I feel like, you know, with everything that's going on in the country with, you know what I'm saying, police brutality, and not just with black people. I mean, we definitely get, like, you know what I'm saying, slaughtered out here every day, but, you know what I mean, it's police brutality regularly. They be wilding and just, you know, using excessive forces on, you know what I'm saying, you know, civilians and shit. I don't feel that that's right, you know what I'm saying? And, you know, I mean, that's something I could talk to my brother about to see, like, if we could definitely put something together just to, you know, bring awareness to that matter, because that matter is definitely important. Y'all can't hear me?
No, right, you gotta talk into
it. It's like you gotta be really close.
Yeah, you gotta like taste it.
Yeah.
Wow. All right, Smack.
No.
My name is Kira Diva. You take a card if you want to.
What's up? Oh, yeah, let me get one of those.
My name is Kira Diva. My question for you is, in a recent interview, you said you prefer bars over names. Can you explain that in detail?
Yeah, because bars over names, that whole situation came about because I just felt that, like, you know what I mean, at a certain point, you know what I mean, a lot of the battle rappers started feeling like once they established their name, they started to get, like, a little, you know what I'm saying, bougie, where, you know, they wouldn't battle certain MCs if, you know what I mean, that MC wasn't on the same level of profile as them.
Right.
But, you know what I mean, there's a lot of MCs that might not be on your profile level, but it's nice as hell. You know what
right,
I'm saying?
Right.
I don't want you to discriminate against a new up-and-coming MCs if I feel he's qualified to give you a run for your money.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So they was ducking battles and, you know, just, you know, not just trying to close the door on new talent. And, you know, I'm one to represent new talent because, you know, I feel that, you know what I mean, new talent make the culture grow. So I'm always going to rep. And I started a movement called Bars Over Names. So that's basically where that whole, you know what I'm saying, format or, you know, movement came about, you know?
That's dope.
Yeah, that is dope. That's
Battle rap fans want to know, is there going to be a cross league battle between King of the Dot and URL?
I mean, we've been talking about that for years, you know what I'm saying? I mean, I had plenty of discussions with Organic about it, but we never seem to get it right, you know what I mean? I'm open to it, you know what I'm saying? I don't know how my partners feel about it, but me personally, you know what I mean? I think it'd be good for the culture, you know what I'm saying? Just to basically, you know, mix the communities and mix the brands. And,
but it's hard because of the border and stuff, so.
The borders, you said?
King of the Dot, right?
Yeah.
So, like.
Yeah, you know, a lot of people can't get in Canada.
Exactly.
Like,
a lot of people can't come here as well, so
we're
going
to have
it's
to probably do it out here if we was to, like, you know what I'm saying, entertain that. But, you know, I'm open, you know what I'm saying? I'm definitely open. I would love to do it.
So there's never really, like, beef with KOTD. Guys work together.
Nah, and we don't work together, but you know, I mean, I don't, it's never no beef. You know what I mean? I don't have no beef with nobody, actually.
Okay.
You know, that's why I'm able to walk around the motherfucking streets with no security. Yeah. What's
up? Right,
you know what I mean? I don't got security.
The streets of LA, like, ain't shit.
Yeah, I feel they doing their thing. You know what I'm saying? They got a good event coming up. You know what I'm saying? You know, they got a lot of key players on their car. So, you know what I mean? Shout out to him, shout out to Ars. And, you know, they got a real dope event coming up. You know what I'm saying? I'm looking forward to it.
So what do you think about, like, international battles between, like, battlers from different countries and stuff like that? Because I know there's always a language barrier.
Yeah.
And most of the time, the international fans always gravitate towards the American battlers, like when Disaster went overseas and stuff like that.
Yeah.
So what do you think about that? And how would we be able to make it in a way that everybody could have a fair chance?
Well, you know, I mean, definitely, like, you know, the States is basically where hip-hop started at. So, you know what I mean? Everybody's going to be extra seasoned and extra sharp, and then, you know, they're gonna know how to really, like, deliver they material in a certain way where they're gonna gain fans from around the world that's gonna appreciate them and love them for that.
Right.
You know, but, you know, when it comes to, like, you know, doing battles overseas and getting them involved, you know, it's just about going out there and conquering the land. This, you know, they just fans of what we do.
Right.
So no matter who goes over there, they're just going to be happy to see these MCs and just be hyped. But there's a lot of dope MCs out there, too, that, you know, don't get the proper promotion and representation that I feel got the necessary skills.
All right. Sorry to cut you off, but we're going to just switch it up a little bit.
Yeah, we got to switch it up a little
bit. We got to, like,
party.
All right, so this party, y'all seem dead. Like,
y'all just looking like y'all grilling the man.
Right.
To be having fun and shit.
Right. Smack. So how... You're traveling a lot. There's a lot of ladies around.
Yeah.
We want to know, are you married? Do you have a girlfriend? What's going on with that?
Saying, like, you know what I mean? I got a couple of friends, but I don't got nothing that, you know what I'm saying, I'm really committed to at this time. You know, what I'm committed to is my grind. So, you know, when I do settle down and get to that point in my life where, you know what I mean, I can have that special person, You know what I mean? That's like a job in itself. So, like, I got this hustle and this grind take up all my time. I don't got no time for no other jobs right now. Like,
where's the violin?
You know what I mean?
Cue the violin.
Would you date a female battle rapper?
You like strippers, though, right? You like strippers, right?
Huh?
You prefer, you like strippers?
What's your ideal woman?
Is a stripper?
I love strippers. I got love for strippers.
Yeah,
I like ladies, too, you know?
Yeah, he loves strippers.
So that means keeping a lot of pussies around it, huh? That's what it's doing?
I mean, not a lot, you know what I'm saying? Because, you know what I mean? I'm not really out there like that, you know what I'm saying? But the people that I feel comfortable with turning up and tickling.
Yeah,
you said tickling.
You can't just be out here tickling everybody.
Nah, they gotta be privileged.
You can't be doing that.
Be ready to fall off. Yeah, be falling out then and all that.
Give the best head, though.
I mean,
yeah,
I
be tickling,
I mean,
you, girl. I'm not lying about the tickle shit.
That might be true. You know what I'm saying?
I'm lying.
That might be true. Like,
in my experience, I would say that's true. Not my experience with you, obviously.
How many dudes with beers, you know what I'm saying, gave you head, though? Like, you know what I mean? For you to talk about, like, let's talk about it. Like, you know what I mean? If you're saying it's true, like, let me know something. Like, you know what I mean? Like, what's
I set myself
like,
up.
But I know, Smack personally, and he's not like,
you know,
we're grilling him about girls, and he's not like that.
So okay, and this is Party and Bullshit Radio.
I ain't gonna be the only one dancing. I ain't gonna be the only one dancing at this party.
What was the question again? I can't hear.
How many dudes with beards gave you had for you to basically to make that statement?
My ex had a beard, so I'm gonna speak for him. He gave me the best head I ever had in my life, so I'm gonna let him speak.
And who you comparing him to, though?
I'm gonna let him speak for the whole beard nation. He's speaking for the whole beard nation.
Who you comparing him to, though? Who you comparing him to?
Maybe another guy that didn't have a beard.
You gotta do like a science experiment now.
We ain't dealing on maybe.
She said the safe answer.
You gotta test it out now with a bare face, a goatee, a mustache. You gotta see which one is the best.
So we got like a million different flavors in here right now. What's your type of female? What do you like? What are you interested in?
I mean, you know, I'm not, you know, I mean,
what's your flavor?
I like, you know what I'm saying? Honestly, like, you know what I'm saying? Like, you know, when I was a young nigga, right, I used to like looks. I used to be looks. I used to like looks, but I'm on loyalty and realness. Like, if a person and a chick is real and she loyal and she riding, you know what I mean? I don't give a fuck how you look, because that's the one that I could count for if anything hit the fan.
But I'm sure that you look at her and you're going to be like,
I mean,
they
all attractive. Everybody attractive. Everybody look, you know what I mean?
We got to set
Smack
you up
I mean,
on
everybody
a date.
Can
all right.
Get it.
Can I say
everybody
something?
Can
let me
get
say
it. I don't discriminate.
Smack.
Everybody could get it.
Smack.
Everybody could get it.
Let me everybody
could
get it.
I know
it.
Smack.
Y'all get in the line. He said everybody could get it. Now I'm joking.
You know what I mean? Everybody can get it.
I know Smack for a long time, and I know him to have a bunch of girls around, and he's never hit on nobody that I've seen, heard of, nothing. He's always like to his...
I'm preserved.
Yeah.
Professional.
You're reserved and preserved.
What does that GM look like?
So you like somebody
what's
more aggressive,
like?
That sounds like.
He's a Cancer. You're a Cancer.
Oh, yeah. Cancer.
Yeah, I'm a Cancer.
Uh-oh.
I'm a Cancer.
Yeah. All my best male friends are Cancers.
Like, you know,
moody.
They're always...
Yeah. Affected by the moon.
You Cancer too?
You know.
Oh, shit, they both...
Oh, wait, what are you, Heineken?
Virgo. Oh, that's the worst.
Oh, my God, no. You got to leave.
Yeah, you got to leave. Virgos, all the Virgos in the building got to go.
You got to leave. Virgos, I know. You got to go.
Now. Fuck with Virgos.
I like Virgos, too. They're really cool.
Nah. Virgos are the coolest. I love Virgos.
You guys got like 18.
What do we do?
And it's like, which one am I going to get today? Which one of you am I going to get today?
No, I think they're assholes. I don't think.
Nah, they got like 18 personalities.
Yeah, nah, you don't switch up ever. I've never seen him switch up. Virgos don't switch up. They'll be assholes.
But I don't know you like that. I don't be with you every day. Now, if I was with you every day, I'm sure you would be Heineken, nice
now
tomorrow.
She want to be with you every day. You see this? Damn, you got 20 dates and you got one. So you good. Y'all good.
Oh, no. That's you. That's you.
You said it. I didn't say it.
You said it. I didn't say it.
I didn't say nothing. So, what about drinking and stuff? Do you drink? How do you, how do you?
Yeah, I drink a little too much.
Oh, I missed that.
Huh? What do you got in your cup?
I got F and vodka right
now. I got
Duce. You
want
some
Duce? I got to
represent for the big homie Fifth. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, we mixing the light and dark.
Queens. You heard? What's
so
up?
Do you go on dates, though? I'm just confused. I can't really see you being like, come on, baby, tonight we going to SDK.
Like, I do, like, a date. Like, I
you do
like,
takeout.
I don't do tech.
I can't hear shit.
Wings and fries.
Like, Sophie know me personally. I do dates every day. Like, yo, come on, let's go
get something
to eat.
It's not really a date. It's like a
power lunch.
I take groups of people out to eat.
He's like one of the homies.
You know what I'm saying? At times, like, yo, come on, let's call your friends. Yo, we going to get something to eat. We going to chill. We going to turn up. Go smoke a hookah. And then we go to strip club. Then we go do what we do.
But then he's always ditching everybody, though. Then he's like always MIA.
When you say ditching, always, I was thinking about the bill. You can't say that.
Oh, dine and ditch.
Please, before the bill comes. Oh, yeah. So, no. Make sure you got your card.
You be in, like, North Carolina somewhere. Like doing that, like, a couple times. Where you at?
Yo, I swear, because you know what I'm saying? Especially, like at the events, it'd be, like, 20 people in a restaurant.
They like, that's Smack.
Everybody
he
be dipping. Yeah, everybody dip on it, and it's like, we stuck at the table like, oh, shit, who
the old dine and ditch.
You know what I'm saying? So, you know.
Well, you know what? We was at Footprints in Coney Island for Angela Yee's event, and I didn't really see you doing a lot of talking either. You was kind of to yourself.
Nah, we was chilling, you know. You know what I mean? It was, you know.
Drinking Hennessy, though.
I was always drinking, you know what I mean? Shout out to Hen Rock, you know what I'm saying? They took care of us that night, you know what I'm saying?
Shout out to Hennessy.
You know what I mean? At the end of the day, like, you know, I mean, I chill. Like, I go off the environment, like, you know what I'm saying? Like, I'm never going to, you know, force myself in. You know what I'm saying? I go with the vibe. If the vibe is some chill out shit, I'm going to be chilling, but... You know, I mean, it's all good.
So what's your favorite?
Fuck that girl? Whose number you got?
Ooh. No, I'm joking. I'm just
What's your favorite city you like being in?
I mean, you like, know, I got a couple of cities. I'm feeling L.A. right now. L.A. is nice. You know
like
what I'm saying?
Smack.
You know, Miami, Atlanta.
Hey, Smack.
What's up?
I ain't cutting you off. What's up?
What's up?
I'm DJ Daisy Duke.
What's up, Daisy?
Core DJs. Tony told me to tell you
what's
hi.
What's up, Daisy? What's up?
So you coming to D.C.? That's where I'm from. I came all the way from D.C.
Yeah,
wow.
That's what's up.
Why you ain't coming to D.C.? What's up with battle rapping in D.C.?
Yeah.
I love battle rap. I like the whole DMV. You know what I'm saying? I was trying to do an event out there for Howard Homecoming, but you know what I'm saying? It just didn't go through with
it
the timing.
It can still be done. Let's do it.
It can be.
Yes,
you know
it can
what I'm
be.
Saying? It can be. But, yo, when is the homecoming, in matter of fact?
Right, 2 weeks.
Oh, you gotta be. You
can't
put
nothing
together.
Yeah, I can't put nothing
happen,
together in 2 weeks. But, you know what I'm saying, that's something that I always wanted to do because, you know what I mean, there's a lot of people out there. And, you know what I'm saying, a lot of my fan base is in that DMV area. So, you know what I'm saying, I definitely want to put on for, like, D.C., Virginia, and Maryland and all
that's
that.
That's why
so,
I had to say something because they roughing you hard
I'm
out there.
I'm trying
like,
to get out
white.
There.
My Periscope is going crazy.
You know, I'm still independent. So, you know what I'm saying, I got to just do what, you know, I could do that makes sense for my company at this particular time. But once I solidify a major situation, I'm going to be everywhere. I promise that's one of the spots I'm coming to first. I promise
then let's
you that.
Meet because I can help you.
All right, so we're going to talk about that.
All right.
Cordial, you know, the West Coast be feeling like you don't give them as much love as you do as the East Coast. What's up with that?
You said what? Bring
the
that
West,
back?
The West Coast be feeling like they don't get enough like love
oh,
from you like you give the East Coast.
Yeah, I mean, I just came from the West Coast. I just did a joint, you know what I'm saying, in L.A. called Traffic. You know what I'm saying? We had a
Traffic
real good turnout. You know what
way.
I'm saying? It was nothing but love. Like, Cali, they be having a nigga ready to relocate out there, like, you know what I'm saying? Because all of the
they
love
ready
that nigga
for
be getting.
You.
But I'm trying to get out there to the West more often. Like, you know what I'm saying? It takes a lot to basically transport, you know what I mean, a whole movement with plane tickets, hotel
right.
rooms,
right.
all that. That shit, it's a lot. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, I can't do it as much as I want to, but, like, you know, when
you're
I
still
get,
doing it, though.
Yeah, I'm doing it,
good.
But I'm not doing it as much as I would like to.
Yet.
So, yet. You know what I mean? But in the future, we
great
we
things
everywhere.
Take time, Smack.
So, yeah. Speaking of the West,
what new
right?
collabs could we hear from different battle rappers that's about
what's your
to come
name,
out?
What's baby? Your what's your name? Tell me your name.
Fancy.
Oh, okay. What's up? All
right,
what's
we
up?
Got 5 minutes left. So, you and up? Then you're the last.
What was that question, Nancy, though? What was
so
that question?
What new collabs? Because I know you did, like, before. I know you usually do like legends, rookies, like versus each other, and then it was 2-on-2. So what new, different battle rap should we look out for?
Oh, I'm doing this. I'm just trying to basically right now just, you know, I'm in a space where I'm trying to get like, you know, major artists involved into the culture just to show they love and appreciation for the art form. So just look out for like collaborations with like, you know what I mean, mainstream artists, whether it be them in the stage in the ring or them hosting or whatever. You know what I mean? Just look out for that. You know what I mean? That's what I'm do just to, so, you know
if
mean,
Drake
can
come through, anybody can come
yeah.
through.
Shout out to Drizzy, you know what I'm saying?
Right, that
love,
was legendary
OVO,
right there.
You know what I'm saying? You already know Drake.
All right,
the
one
homie.
More question before you go, please.
Yeah.
Okay. So
since you the legend of this battle rap and shit,
yeah.
we just gonna ask you who you think won this game and Meek Mill battle.
Game
as far and as what? Meek
like the rhyming?
Yeah.
They both could rap. I think I'm gonna get the, as far as
I'm
rapping,
talking about with these records and yeah, and these records.
I mean, I heard two freestyles. It's just starting. Like it be. I can't really like.
As of now, who
was?
I
can't even say. I'm liking both of what they spitting.
As of now, who won? They both can't get the money.
Honest,
you want to get them both the money?
There's a radar. There's a radar. It's not in the middle.
Yeah, it's like you
it's
know
only
what I mean?
One bag. It's secure the bag. Let's go.
Talking about beef. Yeah. Now you have to do that with us now.
Yeah, nah, secure it's all good. Like I love when artists basically, you know what I'm saying, don't get to it and, you know what I'm saying, basically do what the fuck they do. But it be like, I can't really say
secure
right now.
Secure the bag. Let's go. You're not going to get them right both their money. You got to get
I just heard
them
Beanie do shit, though. That shit's crazy, though. Let's talk about that.
Come on.
I'm fucking with Beanie. Yeah. What's up? Okay. Beanie motherfucking Siegel, the truth. That's what I'm
how
fucking
can people, how can new talent reach out to you?
He on the ground now, though.
What's up,
though? He trying to get back
up. How can new talent reach out to you? Like,
hit me on my Instagram. Everybody else hit me at Smack White. My DM is popping. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. That's where I do all my business.
It's popping, but you see mine though.
Yeah. I hit you this morning on the deal, right? So.
And we want to thank you for coming through.
Word.
You know
word.
This is legendary.
I gotta come back. I felt,
wait, oh, wait, wait, wait. We got one more question.
Before
one more.
You go. Before
and
you
then
go.
You,
before
and
you
then
go.
That's it.
Okay, so I'm Ruby, by the way.
What's up, Ruby?
My question for you is, being that you are OG, triple OG in the game, I wanted to know how you feel about the new era battle rappers versus the old.
I mean, I love the new era battle rap. I think, you know what I'm saying, they display hunger. They display, like, you know what I mean, a lot of more emotions, and they just got more to prove because, you know what I'm saying?
They're hungry.
So, you know what I mean, at the end of the day, I just love, you know what I'm saying, new MC and new talent. So I'm a rep for the new ones and the old ones. So it's all love, you know what I mean? But at the end of the day, you know what I mean, I had a pleasure. You know, I mean, yeah, I feel I've been cheated because, you know what I'm saying, our time was cut. But at the end of the day, we got to do this again. You know what I'm saying?
Yes.
November 20th.
He wanna
you know
come
what I'm
back.
Saying? No.
Anytime. Six. You're welcome.
It's going down at Irving Plaza. You know what I'm
that's
saying? Make sure you buy your tickets in
November
advance.
20th.
Ticketmaster. Come turn up with your boy. You heard?
Y'all make sure y'all go through there. Wear y'all bulletproof vest.
Yeah, nah.
No, no.
No,
I'm joking.
No,
I'm joking.
No.
Y'all be your bulletproof vest. Safe with me.
Bro.
You already know, so I love
too
your
soon?
Ladies.
Too soon?
So I love. You heard?
Sophia Body and L'Oreal.
L'Oreal.
L'Oreal.